This video is a complete tutorial that shows you how you can set up the zkteco f18 access control system, and it also shows you how you can add or enroll users to this particular system so that the users can be verified through this access control terminal. This is another component, which is an electromagnetic lock. It is supposed to be mounted on the door whose access is to be controlled. We will see how it works when we do the setup. I have here an exit button which will be connected into the access control system, and this is to facilitate exit for persons that have already been verified through the access control terminal and are inside the room where the access control is installed. We will be wiring it through these terminals you see behind the device. This is a power supply unit which we'll be using in our setup. I also have here a few wires that we'll be using to interconnect the various components that will be used in this setup. For us to be able to successfully set up this system, or as required in any access control system setup, it is very important to refer to the manual or the start guide of the access control system on how the system can be connected. This particular device, according to its start guide, can be connected to all these devices that you see drawn here. We will soon see how some of these devices listed here or drawn here can be connected as directed by the start guide. These sockets are the provisions through which all the devices listed in the start guide can be connected into the access control system. And we will be using this set of provided cables which will plug into each of these sockets to provide the means of connecting each component into the access control terminal. For example, when we take this set, this is the only socket into which it can fit. So I'll try and connect each of the cables into their respective sockets into which they can fit. So we have all these cables available through which we can connect the various components or devices that we wish to connect in our access control system setup. As mentioned earlier, we will be connecting an electromagnetic door lock, which is the part that will be installed on the door, and we'll also be connecting an exit button for opening the access control from inside the room. Let's now see how the electromagnetic lock connection is done. So we'll refer to the start guide and turn to the lock connection page. This illustration indicates that the lock connection can be done on the connection socket that is located at the bottom left corner of the device, which is referring to these ports that are here on the device. When you look at the table here, it gives further information on the port, including the description of each pin of the port, and you can as well see that the description of the pins have been replicated on the device itself, and this is to guide in the connection of this system. So let's now connect the lock, and this is the detailed lock connection diagram according to the start guide. On this diagram, there is a connection from NC1 which goes to the positive terminal of the lock. So let's go to the device. The NC1 is here, which is 1, 2, 3 from the bottom here. So the NC1 cable corresponds to the same count of 3 from this end. 1, 2, 3. So the yellow cable is the NC1. So I'll take it out of this set. Here is a wire I would like to use in connecting the magnetic lock. So I'll join these two wires by twisting them together. So my joint is done. I will be insulating all joints after we are done with all the connections. So I'll put this one down for now. But this other end of the wire is the end that goes to the positive terminal of the lock, as you can see on the diagram. So I'll join them together by twisting them as well. Again, I'll leave the insulation for now till I finish all the connections. So we'll now establish this connection, which is from the GND on the access control terminal. So I'll first trace the GND on the access control terminal. GND is located here. When you count, it is number 1, 2, 3, 4 from the top. So I'll count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is this black cable. So I'll take it out. And this is the cable I wish to use to connect it. So I'll twist the two cables together. We will be insulating the joints later. So the other end of the one I just joined is going to the negative terminal of the lock. So I'll just join it to the negative terminal of my lock. Let's move on to connect the exit button. Again, the start guide will show us how to connect it. Here is the illustration of how the exit button can be connected. But again, as illustrated, the exit button will also be connected to the connection port that is located at the lower left corner of the device, as indicated here on the diagram. So let's get to connect the exit button now. So we will connect a cable from BUT. BUT is here. When you trace it, it is number 5 from the top, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is the gray cable that is here. So we'll now attach a cable to the gray cable. So it means that this is the cable coming from BUT. So it will go to one of the terminals of the exit button. So I'll lose here. And fix it in and tighten it up. Now there is a connection from GND going to the other point on the exit button. GND is here, which is cable number 4, and it is the black cable. We earlier on made a connection to the GND, so we'll add the new connection to it. So I'll add a fresh cable to this connection. And this end goes to the exit button. So I'll push it in here and tighten. This means that the exit button is also fully wired. When you look at the diagram here, there is a 12 volts and a GND shown. That represents the power supply unit, for which reason we will be using this 12 volts power supply unit. We need just one of the pairs of the power supply units, and so I will be using this particular pair. So I'll put a cable into the positive here, and that goes to COM on the access control terminal. COM is here, and when you trace it, by count, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, which is the red cable. So we'll join the 12 volts to the red cable, which is COM. We'll finally connect the negative terminal of the power supply unit, which is also known as GND. So I'll put this terminal here. I'll connect it to GND on the access control terminal. It is already established that it is the black cable of which we have already connected some cables to. So I'll connect the GND from the power supply to this set of cables which are already on the GND. Now, every device that we intended to connect in this setup has been connected. So now go ahead and insulate all the joints that we've made so far. The insulation is very important in order to prevent short circuits that can cause the damage of your equipment. And so in doing the insulation, it must be done very well before you power up your systems. You would realize that we have not made connection into a lot of the cable sets, and so we can just plug them out of the system to keep our system simpler and tidied. You will notice that this particular one is for power supply into the access control terminal. So I'll connect this adapter that is provided into the system to get it ready for power supply into the terminal. So I can now turn on my power supply unit and then plug up power for the access control terminal as well. The access control terminal is gradually loading up, and so we'll wait for it to fully load up. The system is ready now, and so I want to turn over the side of the magnet that shows the indicator light on the electromagnet, and that is right here as you can see. And since the light is on, that means the electromagnet is active, and that connotes a locked door where these two parts are now strongly magnetized to each other and can only be separated by either the exit button or by verification on the access control terminal. Let's now try the use of the exit button. By pressing the exit button, the light on the electromagnetic lock goes off, and you can then separate the two parts that were formerly magnetized to each other. Once you close the door, that is putting together the two parts of the electromagnetic system, the lights on the electromagnet comes on and the lock becomes active again. Apart from the exit button, you can use the access control terminal to open the lock by getting verified through your fingerprint or through an RFID card that has been programmed into the access control terminal. I'm yet to register my ID card into this particular machine, and so I'm not able to verify this card. The same applies to my fingerprint, else they would have been able to equally open the magnetic lock. So let's now see how user details can be registered or enrolled to this device so that they can be verified on this access control terminal. To be specific, we'll look at how you can add ID cards like this one for each user so that a person can open the access control system using his ID card. We will also look at how you can add fingerprints of the users to this machine so that it will be another means of verifying or opening the access control system aside the use of ID cards. We'll begin by accessing the main menu of the device by pressing this button that is labeled M/OK, where the M refers to menu. So I'll press it. You can see the main menu displayed here. We will be opening this first menu that is labeled User Management, which is already highlighted. So I'll press OK to open it. Now you can see that as I have opened User Management, there is this instruction we can use to create a new user. So I'll press OK in order to add a new user. Under New User, the first item here is User ID. Let's open it up by pressing the OK button. At this point, you can assign a number to this user. It can be User 1, User 2, User 3, and so on and so forth, just to identify the number of users you have entered. But I will assign myself as User 10. So I will enter 10 and confirm by pressing OK. Let's come down to the name of the user. So I'll press OK. Here I can give this user a name, so I'll make it Ben. And then press OK. OK again to confirm. You can see that the name is registered here as Ben with user ID number 10. Let's come down to user role. I will select it. Here the two categories of users are normal users and super admin. The super admin is simply an administrator account on this device, so that after the initial setup of this device, it is only when you are logged into this device through a super admin account that you will be able to add other users to this device and also be able to access and modify settings on the device, whilst normal users are limited to only using their ID cards or registered thumbprints to be able to open the access controlled doors. So I will assign myself a super admin role. So I'll press OK. Now I'll come down to fingerprint. Select it. Here I will have to choose which finger I wish to register on this device. I'll choose my thumb. So I'll bring it down here. Press OK. So I'll have to place my thumb on the fingerprint reader like this. The machine has taken the first sample, so I'll press it again. Also done. I need to do it again. So finally, my thumb is now successfully registered. I will now come down to register my ID card. So I'll come to card number and enter. It says, please swipe card. So I'll swipe my card here. It has picked it. You can see that the card number has been picked up. I wish to also be able to use password to be able to access the access control system. So I'll select password here. This is where I will choose my password. So I will use 4444 and OK. I will repeat the same password again to be able to confirm it. OK. So that means my password is also successfully registered on this device. So we can exit now. Since I have created a super admin account, anyone that comes to try and access the menu of this device will be required to either input the super admin password, or his ID card needs to be swiped on the device to be able to access the main menu of this device. This is a security feature to prevent unauthorized persons from enrolling their details onto this device in order to be able to access a restricted area where the access control is installed. Let me now try my registered ID card on this device. So as I swipe it, you can see successfully verified there with my name and user ID displayed. And in this instance, the door to which this device would have been connected or installed would have opened following a successful verification through my ID card. Let me also try my thumb. You can see fingerprint successfully verified there. My username 10 and my name Ben has also shown up. Adding a second user follows the same process, but you need to first be verified as a super admin and then you can have access to the main menu of this device. The process is the same, but it is the user role that you need to keep at normal user. Else, if you make other accounts super admins, those persons will also be able to add users, modify the settings on this device, and also be able to change many other settings on this device. And that is not what you will need to or you would want to do. You will have to keep other users as the normal users. That is a very important thing to remember. And so that does it for adding users to this device. If you find value in this video, please give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in the next video.